This is the third video of the series, The Chemical Basis of Life. In this video, we will discuss the concept of acids, bases, and buffers. Let us start with the hydrogen ion. As you know, it is released into the medium whenever a hydrogen atom loses a shared electron, with a positive electric charge equal in magnitude to that of an electron. When you eat something sour, like a lemon or a sour gummy, you're experiencing acidity. In the pH world, acids are like those sour candies because they love to give away H+ ions. The more acidic something is, the more it gives away these little sour ions. Acids exhibit varying degrees of willingness to part with their hydrogen ions. Strong acids readily release hydrogen ions such as hydrogen chloride, HCl. In contrast, weak acids, like acetic acid, are a bit more reserved and tend to keep their hydrogen ions close. The released hydrogen ion does not remain free, instead, it combines with another molecule. Now, think of bases as the opposite, they're the ones that can make things a bit more bitter. If you've ever tasted baking soda, though I wouldn't recommend it, you've had a taste of something basic. Bases, like bitter foods, like to accept those H+ ions or provide the hydroxide ions. The stronger the base, the more it can neutralize the sourness of acids. An example of strong bases is a sodium hydroxide, and ammonia is an example of weak bases. As we explained earlier, the water molecule, H2O, consists of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom held together by shared electrons. Under certain conditions, this molecule can undergo a process called dissociation, where it temporarily breaks apart into ions. During dissociation, one of the hydrogen atoms loses its electron and becomes a positively charged ion called a hydrogen ion. The other part, consisting of the oxygen atom and the remaining hydrogen atom, forms a negatively charged ion known as hydroxide ion. And because water molecules can dissociate into hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions, they are considered neutral in pH. So, generally speaking, the pH scale is the measurement of how a particular solution is sour or bitter. To speak more scientifically, the acidity of a solution is measured by the concentration of hydrogen ions and expressed in terms of pH. The pH scale ranges from 0 to 14, where a pH less than 7 indicates an acidic solution. A pH of 7 is considered neutral. A pH greater than 7 indicates a basic or alkaline. The most important point to notice is that the pH scale is logarithmic. In this case, pH equals the negative log of the molar concentration of hydrogen ions. For example, a solution having a pH of 5 contains a hydrogen ion concentration of 10 to the power of minus 5 molars. The logarithmic scale means that each unit change on the scale represents a tenfold change in acidity or basicity. For example, a solution with a pH of 3 is 10 times more acidic than a solution with a pH of 4. In other words, it contains 10 times the hydrogen ion concentration or 10 times less hydroxide ion concentration. To simplify the way in which buffers work, I want to explain a fundamental concept in chemistry, which is equilibrium in reversible reactions. First, what we mean by reversible reactions is that reactants can combine to form products. At the same time, products can react to produce the original reactants. Suppose that we have reactants A and B that interact chemically to generate products known as C and D. In this case, when the reaction starts, the amount of A and B will decrease over time, and simultaneously, the amount of C and D will increase. But at some point, the amount of reactants A and B and products C and D will be fixed because they reach the chemical equilibrium. At equilibrium, the forward and reverse reactions occur at the same rate, resulting in no net change in the concentrations of reactants and products. In this system, if more reactants are added, then more C and D will be produced. Likewise, when more products are added to the system, then some product molecules will interact to reform the original reactants A and B. So, chemical equilibrium refers to a state in a reversible reaction where the rates of the forward and reverse reactions are equal, resulting in a dynamic balance between reactants and products. At the equilibrium, we will have a constant ratio of reactants to products. This ratio is called an equilibrium constant. In other words, the equilibrium constant predicts where a reaction will end up and how much product or reactant will be present at an equilibrium point. It's calculated using concentrations of products divided by concentrations of reactants, each raised to the power of their respective coefficients in the balanced equation. This means that when two molecules of A are required to interact with one molecule of B to produce one molecule of C and two molecules of D, then the respective coefficients of A and D are equal to 2. In contrast, the respective coefficients of B and C are equal to 1. Now, let us explain the concept of buffers and how it works. Buffers are substances or systems that help resist changes in pH, acidity or alkalinity, when an acid or a base is added to a solution. They play a crucial role in maintaining the stability of pH levels in various biological and chemical systems. Buffers are usually a combination of a weak acid and its corresponding conjugate base or a weak base and its conjugate acid. For example, acetic acid, which is a weak acid, and acetate ion, which is its conjugate base, form a buffer system. The key is that the acid and its conjugate base, or the base and its conjugate acid, are in chemical equilibrium. To make it clear, look at the chemical equation of acetic acid dissociation. In this case, you will notice that the reaction is reversible, and a conjugate base is on the other side of the equation. Let us now discover how it works. If you add hydrochloric acid, HCl, the excess hydrogen ions react with acetate ions to form acetic acid. The equilibrium shifts to the left. So, more acetic acid, which is a weak acid, will be formed. So, it minimizes the strong acid hydrochloric acid's effect and its impact on the pH in the solution. If you add sodium hydroxide, NaOH, the excess hydroxide ions react with acetic acid to form acetate ions. The equilibrium shifts to the right. So, more acetate ions will be formed to minimize the impact of the strong base on the pH of the solution. As we said, a weak base and its conjugate acid can also form a buffer system. In a solution containing ammonia, a small fraction of ammonia molecules react with water to form ammonium ions and hydroxide ions. In this case, ammonia is the weak base because it can accept a hydrogen ion when it interacts with water molecules to form ammonium ions and hydroxide ions. Meanwhile, the resulting ammonium ion is a conjugate acid because it can donate a hydrogen ion in the reverse reaction. Suppose you add hydrochloric acid, a strong acid. In that case, it reacts with ammonia and forms ammonium ions, a weak acid, and chloride ions. Suppose you add sodium hydroxide, a strong base. In that case, it interacts with ammonium ions to form ammonia, which is a weak base and water molecule. So, the ammonia and ammonium ion buffer system can resist changes in pH. It achieves this by utilizing the reversible reactions of ammonia and ammonium ions, effectively neutralizing added acids or bases and maintaining a relatively stable pH. That was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.